Hello friends, you are welcome to my YouTube channel MacPN. So in this video we will try to find the deflection at these two points and maximum deflection in this beam by using Macaulay's method. So suppose this is point A, this is B, this is C and this is D. So what is given? A beam of length 6 meter is simply supported with two reactions at ends and carries two point loads of 48 kN and 40 kN at distance 1 meter and 3 meter respectively from the left support. Find the deflection under each load, maximum deflection and the point at which maximum deflection occurs, and value of E and I are given. So first of all we have to find the reactions here. So we will take sum of all the moments about point A should be 0. So RB into this is 6 meter is equal to 48 into this distance 1 meter plus 40 into 3. So we will get 6 RB is equal to 48 plus 120. So we will get equal to 168. So RB will be equal to 168 divided by 6. So we will get RB is equal to 28 kilo Newton. Okay, now RA plus RB will be equal to these two loads. So 48 plus 40 is equal to 88. So RA will be equal to 88 minus RB, which is 28. So it will be equal to 60 kilo Newton. So RA is 60 kilo Newton and RB is 28 kilo Newton. Okay. Now we will try to find the moment at section X. In using Macaulay's method, we have to select the section in the last portion of the beam. So we are selecting this last portion X. At X distance from the last left support, section is XX. So moment at XX will be, due to this reaction, moment will be positive because it is causing sagging. So it will be plus RA is 60 into X, this distance X, minus, due to this it will be hogging moment, so it will be negative 48 into this distance. So this distance will be X minus this, X minus 1 minus this 40 into X minus this distance, X minus 3. Okay, now we know that M is also equal to EI d2y upon dx2. So we will, this is equation number 1, so we will do integration in this equation number 1. So we will get EI dy by dx is equal to 60x square by 2 minus 48 plus c1. In Macaulay's method we have to add the constant of integration just after the first term. Okay, and we will draw the vertical lines in between the different portions. This is for portion 1, this is for portion 2 and this is for portion 3. So we will draw vertical lines, dotted lines, to separate these three. So it will be plus c1 minus, it will be vertical line, minus 48 into x minus 1 to the power whole square divided by 2 minus 40 x minus 3 to the power square whole square divided by 2. So it will become EI dy by dx is equal to 30 x square plus c1 minus 24 x minus 1 whole square minus 20 x minus 3 whole square. So suppose this is equation number 2. So this equation number 2 will be giving us the deflection, slope, because it is dy by dx. Now if we do the integration again of equation number 2, then we will get EI into y is equal to 30 into x cube by 3 plus c1x plus c2, then minus 24 x minus 1 to the power cube divided by 3 minus 20 x minus 3 to the power cube divided by 3. So we will get EIY is equal to 10 f cube plus c1x plus c2 minus 8 x minus 1 cube minus 6.667 x minus 3 to the power cube. So this is equation number 3. There will be vertical dotted lines to separate these three portions. Now what are the condition, boundary condition? You can see that here it is support and here it is also a support. So at x is equal to 0 and x is equal to L, both at both points deflection will be 0 because they are supported. So at x is equal to 0, y is equal to 0, at x is equal to L, y is equal to 0. So we will put the first boundary condition in this equation. So we will get 0 is equal to 0 plus 0 plus c2, and we will consider only this portion because this support comes under section 1. So we will consider only section 1. So from here we will get c2 is equal to 0. Now at x is equal to L, if we go from here to x is equal to L, then we have to face all the loads. So all three portions will be considered. So 0 is equal to 10x cube. So x is L, L is 6 meter. This is 6 meter long. So into 6 cube plus c1 into 6, c2 is 0, minus 8 into 6 minus 1 is equal to 5 cube minus 6.6667 into 6 minus 3 is 3. So 3 cube. So from here we will get 0 is equal to 2160 plus 6 c1 minus 1000 minus 180. Okay, so we'll get 980 plus 6 c1 is equal to 0. So we will get c1 is equal to minus 980 divided by 6. So it will come as minus 163.33. So this is the value of c1. So we can put the value of c1 equation number 3 to get the deflection, and in equation number 2 to get the slope. So we will put this value. EI dy by dx will become 30x square plus c1 is minus 163.33 minus 24x minus 1 square minus 20x minus 3 square. Okay, so this is equation number 4, and EIY will become 10x cube minus 163.33x minus 8x minus 1 cube minus 6.667 x minus 3 cube. So this is question number 5. Now we have to find deflection at under each load. So first of all we will find deflection at C. So YC will become you can see that at C x is equal to 1 meter. So we will put x is equal to 1 meter. So yc will become 1 upon ei into this is 10 into x is 1, so 1 cube minus 163.33 into 1. So we will consider only up to here because this is section comes under first portion. So we will consider only first portion up to dotted line, first dotted line. So it will be If you put the value of EI, then you will get, first of all, let's calculate this. So 10 minus 163.33. So it will become minus 153.33, and it will be in kilonewton meter cube. So if you will convert into newton mm cube, then it will become minus 153.33 into 10 to the power 12 newton mm cube. Now we will put the value of EI. So 1 upon E is given as 2 into 10 to the power 5, 2 into 10 to the power 5, and I is 85 into 10 to the power 6, and into minus 153.33 into 10 to the power 12. So you will get YC is equal to minus 9.019 mm. Minus means it is downward deflection. Now we will find the deflection at point D, at this point. So X is equal to 3 meter we have to put. So we will have YD is equal to EI YD is equal to 10 into 3 cube minus 163.33 into 3 minus 8 into 3 minus 1 is 2 cube. We have to consider only up to here, second section, because D point comes under second section. This is first section, this is second, this is third. So it is under second section. So we have to consider only up to second section. Okay. So we will get the values. So it will be 270 minus 489.99 minus 64. So it will become 283.99 kilonewton meter cube. So if it we will convert into newton mm cube, then it will be minus 283.99 into 10 to the power 12 newton mm cube. Okay, so YD will become 1 upon EI into this value. So 1 upon EI is 2 into 10 to the power 5 into 85 into 10 to the power 6 into minus 283.99 into 10 to the power 12. So it will become minus 16.7 mm. So this is the deflection at point D. Now we have to find the point at which maximum deflection will occur. Okay, so how to find this? At points where maximum deflection will occur, that at that point the slope will be 0. So dy by dx will be 0, and you can see that there are chances that maximum deflection will occur between the points C and D. So we will consider up to D, only up to second section. So we will put dy by dx is equal to 0. From here 30x square minus 163.33 minus 24 x minus 1 square is equal to 0. If you will rearrange this, then you will get 6x square plus, if after simplifying, plus 48x minus 187.33 equal to 0. If you will solve this, this is a quadratic equation, then x will become minus 48 plus minus, we have to find the roots, minus b plus minus root b square minus 4ac upon 2a. We are applying this formula. So 48 square plus 4 into 6 into 187.33 divided by 2 into 6. So it will come as 2.87 meter. So at 2.87 meter from left, maximum deflection will occur. And what will be the maximum deflection? So EIY max is equal to 10. In this equation, we will consider only up to this point because maximum deflection is occurring in the second section. So 10 into 2.87 cube minus 163.33 into 2.87 minus 8 into 2.87 minus 1 is equal to 1.87 cube. Okay, so if you will solve this, then you will get 236.39 minus 468.75 minus 52.31. So you will get 284.67 kilonewton meter cube. If you will convert it into newton mm cube, then you will get 284.67 into 10 to the power 12 newton mm cube. Okay, so y max will become 1 upon ei, and this value of E and I are given, so we'll put these values. So y max will become 284.67 into 10 to the power 12 divided by EI. So E is 2 into 10 to the power 4, 5, and I is 85 into 10 to the power 6. So it will become minus 16.745 mm. Okay, so this is the maximum deflection for this beam. Okay, so what are the asked in the question? Deflection under each load, we already find maximum deflection. We have found this value. This is 16.745. It is downwards because it is negative. And the point at which maximum deflection will occur, so we have already found that, 2.87 meter. So we have solved this question completely. If you have any doubt, then please ask in the comment section. And if you like this video, then please share and subscribe my channel. And thanks for watching this video.